welcome to the show. My name is Anisha. Now, we just saw some Derek. You know, he's the Uganda movie ambassador. He took us through that. But now it's my time, my segment, a place where I let you go through love, you know, see what's happening on the lover's side. Now, I have a special guest with me. She's called Chantal. Chantal, welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you, Anisha.
And then I'm very sure we're going to battle it out today, because I already know that me and Chantal, just by the look of things, we're on different sides. Omanye, you can tell someone that you're going to, you know, be on good terms with, and the person you're going to collide with. Because even I'm putting on green and you're putting on maroon, and those colors don't match. Anyway, so tonight on the show, I'm asking Chantal, finances. Yeah.
Yes.
Do you think that in a relationship, a woman is, it's mandatory for a woman to contribute in a relationship, her finances? She's supposed to chip in. You know, if she makes money, you're like 50, 80 or 50, 50. What do you think?
It's supposed to be 50, 50. A woman is supposed to chip in.
Why is that?
Because you're in a relationship, you're supposed to take care of the house. You're supposed, both of you have to share roles.
Mm-hmm. So, can I ask you, cooking and cleaning and giving birth to kids and taking care of the household, isn't that a role by itself?
No, that's different.
Mm-hmm.
If we have a maid, then you're working as well. I pay for the maid, I buy the food, I buy all the supplies for the kids. You're supposed to chip in.
Why should I? Let me tell you something. The reason these days, ladies, women actually have opted for maids is because they're working. You understand?
Yes.
So it's hard for you to go at work, run back at home, take care of the kids. So you need a little support.
Uh-huh.
But even though you have a maid, Chantal, we all know, omkaziwe nyumba, mkaziwe nyumba. At the end of the day, if she knows, she'll still go back and see that the house is fixed. So even these maids, they're just helping you out. They're not doing fully. They're not doing your job fully. You still go back once in a while. You still cook for the house, take care of the children.
But if you do that, do you think all the women do that? So let's look at two types of women here.
Mm-hmm.
There is this woman who is working.
Mm-hmm.
She goes back home. The maid has prepared the food. She has bathed the kids. She has taken good care of the kids, let's say. And then there is this woman who stays home.
Mm-hmm.
And she takes care of the kids. She does not work. Now, that kind of woman is not supposed to contribute anything in the house.
First of all,
you're just supposed to leave money for her to do the shopping.
Chantal.
And then this woman who is making money is supposed to contribute. That's a must.
Women like you are going to discourage women like me from going to work, going to school and getting an education, because we know that once we have our own, they cannot give us. Men are not supposed to take care of us. Even in the holy books, we all know that it is a man's job to take care of a woman. And me, I believe in the saying of, your money is ours, but my money is mine. Let me tell you something. Because I am a degree holder and I work in a bank, or I'm a doctor, does that mean that he cannot take care of me? Is it my problem that Naso?
Now that's why you go wrong.
Are you discouraging me from
going
to school?
No. Stop looking at a man as a financial security.
Mm-hmm.
You look at him as someone who is supposed to be your financial...
But how comes...
Whatever.
You're saying not. I should not look at a man as a financial security.
Yes.
But how comes for me they look at me like a housewife? They look at me like some sort of home slave.
You just present it like that.
Mm-hmm.
If you're stay home mother and you do all that work, you do that, that's now when you're what? Like you described it. But if I'm this woman who goes to work, who does, people won't brand me like that.
Okay, let me give an example. You've already said your thing, that, okay, now for us who go to work, try to make a living, support the family, we should chip in because we have. But the women who sit home are supposed to be taken care of.
Yes.
You understand? Mm. Number one, me, I keep saying it live on live TV, I've never supported emancipation because... This thing was, people look at it as a good thing, but to me it's not. You understand?
Okay.
I prefer our African culture setting, you understand, whereby a woman does her job. Because look at it this way, Chantal.
Then if you're going to follow that African setting, then even the working, you should even can stop working in a bank or like or whatever you say.
Do you know the reason why? Yeah, but do you know the reason I have to work in
then
a
be
bank?
The African woman, the typical but African woman. Sit at home, take care of your kids, raise your kids.
Chantal, you know the reason I cannot do that is because there are men there who do not do their job. There are men who leave their women with no money. They don't even know how their children are. Tasasura school fees, takuwa centers are men. There is nothing. You are forced to go as a woman and do a man's job.
But why would you be with a man like that?
Let me tell you something. You don't choose, Chantal. This world is funny. These men come to you, they make moves on you. He comes to you, he's driving a good car, he tells you he's going to take care of you. Chantal, the moment you get pregnant, 9 months after, haven't you heard of a woman who told you he disappeared? I gave back to twins Nandeka. You understand? Men leave their responsibilities behind, and it is up to a woman to take care of the family. That is the reason why women these days have to do a man's job.
Now, there is a difference between a marriage and this relationship.
But a relationship leads to marriage. Yes. It should at least.
Okay, there is this boyfriend-girlfriend relationship and there is this husband and wife relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So this girlfriend-boyfriend relationship, the way you first present yourself, if you come and spend money on your woman, and if she's also spending money on you, even when you get married, that's how it's also going to remain.
Mm. Unfortunately, that is how you're stating it, but that is not how life presents to you. Life slaps you in the face and shows you a different side of someone. Someone will change. Let me tell you something. Haven't you heard of people who write in Mama Tendo and all these articles?
Mm-hmm, yes.
Dear Mama Tendo, I've been with my husband, I've been with my boyfriend for 5 years. He was such a good man, but the moment you put a ring on it, he started drinking, he started doing drugs, he stopped taking care of me. People change.
But so why? Why don't you look at that reason? Why does a man change? Why? It might be you.
It might be me.
Yes.
That is granted, it might be me, but it also could be him.
Why would a man start drinking? He hasn't been drinking before, but when he gets married to you, that's when he starts drinking. Maybe you're nagging.
I'm nagging.
Yes.
Can I ask you a question? When our children grow up and have raised them alone as a single mother, and then you come back with your staggering self, and then you tell them, your mother was nagging, will they forgive you?
No.
I think that's a little bit very childish for a man to take up. Because I'm nagging, isn't there things like marriage counseling? Is that the only solution to drink or to stray? You understand? Let's get back to our point of finances. Ah, you're being very smart by the aspect of myself. You're taking me for a ride. This is a hard show by the way, you guys. Let's go back to the
but finances. Once, let me tell you, once you get into a relationship, you're supposed to discuss your roles. Are you going to contribute? You're going to contribute this. I'm also going to contribute this.
Chantal,
that's the
thing. I told you orange and maroon don't click. They don't click. What do you? I don't even want to hear these things.
Yes, you have to contribute. You have to chip in. Not like contribute 100. Oh, okay. Like you are saying, it's supposed to. Now let's say it's 100%. You'll take the 80% and I'll take the 20%. Because there are some simple things a man is not supposed to buy in the house.
We'll be right back with me and Chantal battling it out to see, are women in charge of finances? Yes, should they contribute to the finances or not? But let's just take a quick break. I'll be right back after this.